Yes, sir. Houses, horses, and hogs. That's the Sanford Show. You know, I've been checking my email, and it's stinking crazy. It is stuff everywhere. I've got so many emails, Doug, that it backed up and said I had too many.
Too many?
Yep.
How do you have too many?
I don't have no idea, but I got too many.
Does that mean you need to delete some?
How do you delete all of them? I'm just going to quit reading them. Where's Rodney at anyway? He down there getting one of them hand massages? Hey, Linda. We got a water leak. Oh, great. Oh. Oh, my Lord. It's a flood. Let me see. That's awesome. What do you mean, what'd you do? Wow, that's awesome. I don't know what y'all did. It's a flood. Hey, Doug, get Noah's Ark. We're flooded.
Hey, I'm here. I'm finally here.
You don't need a shovel. You need a mop.
What do you mean I don't need a shovel?
Our producer went in the back and flooded the bathroom.
Well, come over here and tell us what happened. We're on breaking news. You got a microphone? Come tell us.
Well, I kind of went to the bathroom.
How you kind of go to the bathroom?
Well, I guess you
How does that work?
You kind of squat or you kind of don't.
You kind of, well, you either you do or you don't. How does that work?
I don't know what happened back there.
I'm sorry I'm a little bit late. I was trying to find a parking place. Somebody parked right in front of the front door right there. I couldn't even get in.
That'd be me.
Oh, I finally called up.
I like that shovel. That's a big pile down there needs to be moved, by the way.
Family dollar. Well, I ain't...
You ain't even wore the stickers off yet.
No. Well, it's a light snow. It's a light snow. That's why I haven't wore stickers off. But that don't mean I ain't been working. You know, some of these people just get out and ride around in this snow all day long filming stuff. They ain't doing no work. This right here is work. Someone's got to work for a living. Yep. Someone's got to work for a living. Sound like you got a plumbing job to do.
No, it's leaking from the ceiling.
Oh, the ceiling?
We got a water leak.
How's a toilet leak from the ceiling?
It ain't the toilet. It's the roof.
Oh, the roof?
The roof is leaking.
Oh, you know what that means, don't you?
A roof
leak.
Oh,
that snow up there ain't got shoveled off.
It's a roof leak.
We're going to have to go up there and shovel that snow off.
I ain't doing it.
Well, somebody going to have to.
Here's somebody squalling back there. Somebody getting wet.
Don't they know we're doing a show?
I don't think they care.
Well, if you don't mind, I'll go get me something to drink.
I got me something.
You know, I have been shoveling so much snow I done threw my back out.
That really wouldn't be hard to do, believe it or not.
Seriously.
And another thing, be careful out there because it's not cold right now, but sometimes the cold air, when you get to shoveling, it really affects your heartbeat.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Especially a guy like you that ain't used to, doing a lot.
What? Oh, trust me.
You're more used to sitting behind a computer and Facebooking all day.
No.
And
trust me.
Reading texts and emails.
No.
And, FaceTiming and Snapchatting and no. Pinteresting and... No. And what's that other one? Tweety Birding. I mean, that ain't work. I mean, your thumbs are massive, but you know what?
Trust me, I get my heart rate up enough. It can handle the shoveling
in
the
nice
snow.
Nice screwdriver.
But I have thrown my back out. So I am really pleased to think about my, you know what?
No, I don't, but I'm sure you're going to tell me.
You know what I'm thinking about? I threw my back out. What do you think I'm thinking about?
Probably some pain meds.
Oh, man, I got an appointment today. Get me a full body massage.
You going to get another one of them man massages?
From the toes up, brother, I sure am.
I ain't letting them guys rub on me.
No, ain't no guy. I won't let no guy touch me. You kidding me? I won't let no guy. No.
Hey.
No.
Over the week, snowed, right? Weekend.
I thought, yeah, it did.
Well, I went to get my boots, and I realized my son had took my boots from me.
Your son stole your boots, or he just took them?
He took them.
Took them like he owned
them. So he had cranked the motorcycle so many times, the right boot had a hole in it.
Like he done paid for them himself.
So I went and got me a brand new pair. Check it out. Check it out.
Man, goodness. Not,
that's a pair of boots right there, folks.
Where are you planning on walking?
Anywhere I want them. Waterproof.
Yeah.
Insulated.
Woo. Man. You're getting deep around here.
Telling you, you see,
that.
The thing I like about it, they kind of, well, I got them a little dirty. I need to polish them up.
I could have used boots like that a few years ago.
Yeah. Yeah, you coming here. Yeah, you had to dig your way out a few things.
Man, them are some good-looking boots.
They are comfortable, yeah. Too.
And here I am today wearing my Converse.
Yeah, you're kind of strange.
I'm wearing Converse tennis shoes. Well, it ain't snow on the ground.
Well,
anymore.
I wanted to try my best to buy a pair of boots that if I wore to work or in my jeans, it would be okay.
Well, whose advice did you ask? Was that okay?
That's the only pair they had left that would fit me.
Okay.
They all was camouflage.
Your wife know you dressed like that when you left this morning?
Yeah.
She let you walk out the door looking like that?
Yeah.
She don't love you at all?
No. Sometimes I wonder.
How many years you said you've been tied
21.
Down? 21. Woo.
That's a good number.
A good time for a change, what that
Ooh. Is. I can't afford change.
21.
I ain't like you. I can't afford change.
21.
Everybody says, you know, change is good. I can't afford that kind of change.
Yeah, but yeah, that's what they say. They say the only person that appreciates change is a two-year-old that's crapped his pants. But I'm telling you what, I can learn to appreciate it. That's for sure.
Yeah, well.
So, did you have fun in the snow? I know you was out with
you. I did.
Yeah.
I did. I didn't never have to call Harbor one time to get me out either.
Not one time.
He called twice, said, I need to come get you. Nope.
I can't believe that.
He called me again. You need me to come get you? Nope.
Well, he's getting everybody out.
He called me thrice, said, man, I'm going to get you out. I said, I ain't stuck, pal.
That's hard to believe.
I even went down the field pot, down in the bottoms, and took beautiful pictures.
Beautiful pictures.
Yeah.
What you take them with?
I took them with the brand new Canon.
Brand new Canon.
Brand new Canon.
Well, don't get no better than that then.
I tell you, it's something about that new marina with the water good and smooth, blue from the cold and snow all over it.
Yeah.
It's pretty, man.
It is pretty. Yeah. Yeah, I saw some pictures of that. Posted.
Well, I went down to the bottom of the dam going to take a picture. When I got out of the truck, I made a stumble and fell because I didn't have my boots yet.
Oh,
dropped my camera in the dang snow.
Oh, my goodness.
So, long story short, I got back in and wore my toes up.
Yeah.
And I went straight and get some boots.
Yeah.
Down here at the big Walmart intersection, that little shoe place right there.
Hold on, man. I don't even know what you're talking about. There's a shoe place
there
at the Walmart
Shoe Depot.
Shoe Depot.
Let me tell you what. I went down there on Fridays, and they selling out of boots. Every country boy in the world.
You mean?
There was a, I thought there was, you know what I thought it was?
What?
I thought it was a four-wheel drive bar. All four-wheel drives lined up down through
there. You had all them rednecks in there trying to buy some boots.
No one trying. They were buying them. You know what I had to do?
What would you have to do? Fight your way?
I had to go through a dozen pair to find a pair that fit because it was all gone. I wear 12. They're gone.
You don't wear no size 12?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
You wear a size 12?
I do, yeah.
That's hard to believe.
I got a big foot. I just never finished growing.
A size, size 12?
Got a big foot.
You kidding me?
No.
So your foot ain't caught up with your body ain't caught up with your foot yet.
Well, it's beginning to. It's beginning to catch up. Check that view out.
Well, I wear an 11.5.
Look at that, Doug. Look at that, producer, man.
Yeah.
That's all I got.
Now, that right there,
look,
folks.
That's a good side profile.
Folks, that right there shows that being inside all winter long during the snowstorm is bad for your health. Speaking of, I've made myself a new appointment to go see Dr. Favaro. You've been talking about him forever. You told me to go see him.
Yeah, he's a good doctor.
So I'm going to have to go see Dr. Favaro. I know what he's
well,
going to tell
me. Well, Dr. Favaro's office I go to, and I'm using William Schuff, which is one of his doctors there. But, man, they take good care of me. Got me healthy.
What's that little lady's got working for him?
I want to say Dr. Dijon, but that's the teeth lady.
No, that's the girl to make you smile.
That's the smile lady.
She sure is. She's
but yeah, hey, I got to say, all my family's got straight teeth.
Hey, let me tell you this. Dr. Jones and Dr. Deshaun, now they're working with an office down in Danville. They are like the center of this new scanner thing, this digital scanner. I was just there just the other day. You know, normally you go into an orthodontist and they they do all these impressions, got all that gooey stuff.
It's nasty.
Got
it used to be nasty.
And you swallow some of it, and it's like, and you're gagging. Now they lay you back in this Lazy Boy, and this girl takes this thing like a cucumber. She shoves it down you. Well, she moves it around everywhere and takes pictures. And they have, it's what you call a digital scanner, and it is really awesome. It's painless.
Yeah, I can remember when I was getting my impressions and all old molds and things, and it was rough.
I would say it's tasteless, but I did taste a little bit of lip gloss from the girl that was before me.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess, I don't know, they might have not cleaned it up.
That's pretty bad, because I remember mine's kind of like an onion. Tastes like
an onion?
Yeah.
Really,
had
an onion?
An onion taste.
Well, listen, right now is, you know, now's the best time to call and make an appointment over, because they got some discounts going on you wouldn't believe.
You can't beat it. My whole family's got beautiful smiles due to Dr.
You know what y'all do? Dr. Jones.
Dr. Jones.
What you should do is follow them on Facebook, and you'll see all these kids that are smiling, that are enjoying life, and coming soon. I'm going to post a few videos of them saying what they think.
It's really cool that when I was a teenager, Dr. Jones done all my braces, and now we're in business together.
Yeah.
He's still in business, and he's helped thousands and thousands and thousands.
Over 30 years, man.
30 years worth of orthodontist work. Yep. And now it's really, I think it's cool.
It is cool.
He's got braces on your kids. He's got braces on my kids.
You know what's
so cool
about
that? I mean, it's just awesome.
Look, I was in his office just yesterday, and there was this lady that was in there, and she said, "You put braces on me when I was 14, and now I'm bringing my son in here who's 14, and you're putting braces on him." She said, "Are you ready to retire?" And you know what he said? He said, "No way. Right now, I'm in my prime. I'm having more fun now doing what I do than I've ever had in my life."
He is.
I love what I do. I love helping people. I'm having fun, and I ain't retiring no time soon.
He loves to work.
So, this new doctor.
He's got a good staff, though.
He does. Oh, man. Wonderful staff. Well, look, when you go somewhere and he's had the same staff for 30 years, some been there 20 years, I mean, that speaks for itself.
Well, I think you're kind of looking at the staff at a different angle.
What do you mean?
You know, Dr. Dijon, DeJejo, DeJanyo.
Well, I like to call her Dr. D.
Dr. D. You're kind of looking at Dr. D from a different angle.
What do you mean?
Well, I know you're going over there to see Dr. D, and you don't need no braces.
No, I ain't seen her in a long time. She only's in there Thursday and Friday, I think. Because she's in
It's kind of strange you always changing your Monday appointments to Friday.
Anyway, she's a pretty amazing doctor, though, by the way. She got a large following. These younger kids are absolutely in love with her and want to keep her around.
I think there's some older guys really following her too.
I don't think you got very many older guys over at an orthodontist doctor. I wouldn't think.
Anyway, yeah, they call that stalking now.
Anyway, we're trying to tell you that they got the areas, or I would say the region's only digital scanner, which means when you go in and you want something like Invisalign, or you got to have x-rays or some pictures taken of your teeth, you don't have to go old school. You just take that little scanner thing. You just lay back in the Lazy Boy and let them take pictures. Do I hear water?
Yeah, we're flooding.
What is going on?
Doug, let's take a break and see where that water's coming from.
Well, let's do that. That's I'm
You don't need the shovel. I'm telling you, you need a mop.
Yeah, I'm feeling a little uncomfortable about this.
Oh, well.
And it's not coming up out of the floor.
I'm Paul Ford. People at Quick Lube think we're just an oil change. We now offer tires at Quick Lube. Stop by and get a set of Cooper tires for a $70 mail-in rebate. Also at Quick Lube, we offer engine repair, computer diagnostics, tire rotations, radiator flushes, and much, much more. Remember, at Quick Lube, we're more than just an oil change, serving you with two locations, Martinsville and Ridgeway. And visit us at quicklubeva.com or like us on Facebook for coupons and discounts.
Bankruptcy, divorce, medical bills, you need a vehicle. Do not wait another minute. Even if you have credit problems, you're approved. Save up to $3,000 on the Nissan Altima or 0% financing for 72 months on the new Altimas or Sentras. It's vacation giveaway month at Jim Mills Nissan. Purchase a new vehicle this month and Jim Mills will send you and your family on vacation. Visit Jim Mills Nissan across from the Martinsville Speedway or visit us online at jimmillsnissan.com.
Hi, I'm John. I'm the pharmacist here at Rocky Mount Family Pharmacy. We'd like to invite you to come visit us and get all your prescription needs and healthcare needs filled here. We save you money on your prescriptions. We offer free delivery. We offer a family atmosphere. We treat you like family. We're located in the Shul Shopping Center on Route 40 West, like you're going to Ferrum here in Rocky Mount. That's 1165 Franklin Street. And our phone number is 489-5400, and that's area code 540. Come see us today.
Look here to find job opportunities close to home. Use our virtual job fair as an opportunity to apply for job positions in our region in the comfort of your own home. So what are you waiting for? Click submit today.
Told you, man, you need to budget.
Budget?
Yeah.
Man, this is ridiculous. My power bill has went up $100.
Well, I'm telling you, if you get on that budget, it's just the same every month. It don't matter.
$262.85.
$260 what?
$62.85.
Wow. That's a whole lot cheaper than my budget. My budget's $300.
Well, that's because you trying to be like them fancy people living in big houses and dual heat pumps and big TVs and people working on the yard and people working on the house. And
well, no,
I don't try to live with the Joneses. I live with the Halls.
Listen to me. When you got a split-level house, you don't have a choice but to have dual heat pumps. That's how it's set up. Can't have one heat pump in the basement or the upstairs.
Just saying.
That's just how it works. That's why, you know, a budget.
Next thing you know, you're going to move down there in Mulberry with the rest of them boys and all be all snobby, your head up real high. Walk like this.
No, I ain't going to get that good. No. No, I ain't going to do that to nobody. I won't go live in Mulberry. I'm happy where I'm at in Collinsville. I like the city life.
I can't afford the taxes in Mulberry.
I'm going to be quite honest with you. If I'm more than a minute away from Sonic when I'm craving ice cream, I can't survive. I got to be a minute away.
You know,
away.
From living out in the country to living down here in Collinsville, it probably has been a major change for
oh,
you.
Oh, yeah, at least 20 pounds.
Is it 20 pounds?
Yeah, man.
That's
it's,
not bad. I was guessing 30.
Well, I mean, we're talking about... Oh, he was?
Yeah.
Well, we're talking about, like, what, at least about a two-year span there. So, I mean, you know, a couple pounds a month, that ain't nothing to it. But, you know, all these restaurants, they're getting in this fight for this 4 for $4 right
now. I like
now.
It. Yeah, they now, battling it out.
You know, it's hard to pass up a dinner for $4.
Mm, cheap.
I mean, you go to Wendy's, you get 4 for $4. You go to Burger King, you can get 5 for $4. You go to Hardee's, you can get 4 for $4. You go to McDonald's, you can get 2 for $2. I mean, you just can't lose.
It is pretty cheap.
Yeah. Well, I mean, when you start talking about
feeding, but you know, it's kind of like bacon.
Well, hold on.
You
got to
be careful.
You got to be careful with bacon.
You got to be careful.
Bacon's good.
Those 4 for $4s, 2 for $2s, 5 for $4s, all of them are just like bacon.
Okay.
I don't know if you know this. Bacon and women have a couple things in common.
Well, you're completely out of my league now because I don't have a clue what you're talking
about. Do you
about
like bacon?
I like bacon.
You like bacon.
I like
well,
bacon.
Right.
Bacon makes my mouth water.
All right, here's the thing. Women and bacon have 4 things in common.
Really?
They look good.
Okay.
Taste good.
I agree.
Smells good.
Absolutely.
And slowly killing us fellas, just inch by inch. That's the same thing all these other places are doing. Just slowly killing you, brother.
Is that last one a subliminal message?
It's the truth.
It's the truth.
It's the truth. Slowly getting us.
Well, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm going to be lucky to live another 50 years. And I figure if I'm going to live another 50 years, I may as well enjoy all the bacon I could eat.
I really like bacon, too.
Yeah.
See, I mean, everybody likes bacon. Bacon makes everything better.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
I don't care what you got.
If you got nothing but bread...
Just make a bread sandwich with bacon.
Throw some bacon.
Bacon
on.
Sandwich.
Yeah.
Can't beat it.
Yeah.
Crunchy.
Crunk.
Yeah. Whoa, makes crunchy. Me hungry now.
Crunchy.
I love bacon.
Yeah.
It don't love me, though.
You know, one thing I am really, really craving
what?
Is pork. But you know what?
You won't be able to walk next week.
I'm already having problems with my right foot and my left knee. I'm about to die. About to die. I'm thinking about my massage later on this afternoon, and I'm thinking how bad I want it, and I'm thinking how bad it's going to hurt. Seriously.
Not good.
And I take that medicine to make it all go away.
Oxycodone?
Yeah,
is that what that's for?
But it makes me so stinking sick. I'm going to tell you this. It's the truth. Over this snowstorm, I was hurting, man. The cold weather moved in. There's several times where I was out by myself covering news stories.
Yeah.
By myself.
Yeah.
And I got cold.
Yeah.
And I got wet.
Yeah.
And then the gout sets in, man. And
how did gout set in because you were cold and wet?
Well, I mean, don't you know anything about arthritis? I mean, you got arthritis.
No, I ain't.
When you get cold and wet, your arthritis just starts kicking your butt. It literally just
don't really bother me.
It really was a. It was bad. It was bad. So then I took the medicine to get rid of the gout, and then the medicine I took for the gout
made
me sick.
How you know if it was gout? If it was gout or arthritis?
When you get gout, you know you got gout.
Cold and wet don't cause gout.
Listen. There was times in my
younger years. You eat some bacon.
No, I eat pork. I'm telling you, it was in my younger years. I'll be honest with you. In my younger years, I seriously considered amputation.
Whoa.
I would hurt so bad in certain parts.
We can do that right now.
I was seriously hurting so bad. And if you've got this, you know what I'm talking about.
What's bothering you?
Well, right now it's my knee. You can't amputate just my knee. The rest the rest of my leg is okay.
Well, I can tell you what, I can probably make the pain go away.
A sharp edge like that's going to cause more pain, not less.
But I can make the pain in your knee go away.
Listen, I'm not from Bassett. I'm not falling for this. I'm just trying to tell people that there is medication for gout. But the best thing to do is just stay away from pork.
I'm telling you.
Processed food.
It ain't.
When you get stuck at home.
I just told you what bacon and women had in common.
And bacon is, okay, bacon is processed food. But listen, if you get stuck at home in a storm and all that processed food
laying around. All you gotta do is get rid of your women, you heal and you're gonna heal up.
Hold on a minute, you just said bacon and women.
I just explained to you the four steps of bacon and women.
Well, I'm going
to
be honest with you. I'm okay with getting rid of the bacon.
You phase out the women the bacon, you're going to heal up.
I'm going to phase out the bacon starting today.
But you got to get the other
bacon
in there, too. You can't.
I'm going to phase out the bacon.
You're going to keep one killing you.
I'm going to order me a Baconator no bacon. I'll do that today.
We going to order a girlfriend with no girlfriend?
What are you talking about? What's a girlfriend
got to
do with
it? You got to phase it out.
What's a girlfriend got to do with bacon?
You're going
to
be hobbling by Monday. Your knee going to swell up. Your foot going to be crooked.
I'm not going to have no more bacon, I promise. From this day on, my New Year's restitution is going to be no more bacon.
Yep, I can see it now, Doug. He'll be hobbling next week. Especially if you go all women, no bacon. Man, you're in trouble.
What does women got to do with bacon?
I done explained it to you. They're all in common.
I thought it was an analogy. I didn't know you
were
trying to.
That's not an analogy.
I had no idea you were assuming.
There's no assumption. It's statistically proven.
Well, I don't think you need to accuse that I love women as much as I love my bacon, because you can look at me and tell me that I love my bacon.
Well, you got a point. What, they both killing you?
I like to see the look on their face when I order a Baconator today. Wait, no bacon. That's going to be funny right
there. I got a feeling you're going to order a Baconator with a side of bacon.
Yeah. Hey, you want me to tell you one disappointing fact? No matter how many times you dip a McDonald's chicken nugget in that Chick-fil-A sauce, it still tastes like a McDonald's chicken nugget.
You going through the drive-thru getting Chick-fil-A sauce again, then going and getting cheaper nuggets?
No. It's just I only crave Chick-fil-A on Sundays. Now, how stupid is that?
Well, maybe you should go by on Saturday and put it in the refrigerator.
Well, what I do is when I go by on Saturdays, I get extra sauce.
Mm-hmm.
And then on Sundays, I go to McDonald's to get my two for two.
It just ain't the same.
It ain't the same. It's very disappointing.
It is.
It is very disappointing.
You know, I don't remember last time I ate McDonald's or Wendy's.
Well, that's because your kids are older. When you got younger kids, that's all you do. You live off
of
Happy Meals.
See, I don't live in town.
You don't live in town, but you work in town.
But they don't.
They don't ever say, Daddy, on your way home, will you pick up something?
If they do, it's pizza.
If my phone rings and it says my son or my daughter, I guarantee you they're asking for food.
Well, you're right there.
Guaranteed.
But mine always ask for pizza.
Pizza.
Or milk.
So you stop at Papa's Pizza and pick
Papa's
up pizza and milk.
Usually get pizza.
Do they have milk down there for you?
No, I got to go to the Village Market.
Oh, I figured that they already started having milk
home a
down
lot.
There for you.
We eat at home a lot.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I guess
you know what I had
for
supper last night?
What?
Pinto beans and cornbread.
You got to be kidding me.
cooked in the crock pot all day.
God, seriously.
I blowed the covers off twice last night.
Goodness. You know, I heard so many people in that snowstorm, that's what they did. They made pinto beans and cornbread. And I'm thinking to myself, why you want to be locked in the house, snowbound, making pinto beans and cornbread? That right there, you killing yourself right there.
I woke up last night, I was freezing. My wife said, covers in the floor. I said, why? She said, you blowed them over.
Well, she also cracked the window, I'm sure.
Yeah, well, she probably did. It's kind of cold.
Don't be lighting a candle around your house, that's for sure.
But she bought this new pressure cooker.
Okay, yeah.
And she put them pinto beans in there.
In a pressure cooker.
And guess what?
What?
Put some bacon in there with it.
Oh, my God.
Pressurize that bad boy.
She killing you, man. She
I told you. See what I told you?
She pays you
slowly.
And she feeds you. You got to catch on to this thing. So
two-minute warning.
Women and bacon are in common. They're slowly killing us.
Did he say two-minute warning that fast?
Yeah.
We're having fun, man. It's just time flies by.
Well, I'm kind of glad it's over because I'm really craving bacon, and I don't care.
Yeah, we're going to have to call somebody about that. In there.
Yeah.
There was water coming down around that electrical thing.
Still is.
And I ain't close enough to Jesus to be messing with it, so I advise you find somebody, you go fix it yourself.
I ain't touching it.
Yeah, well, I ain't touching it. That's true.
I ain't touching it.
All right, so we need to go no red meat, no pork. So where you want to go eat?
Oh, I didn't say I was phasing any of that out. I'm lean and mean.
Well, I mean, I've got to be smart here. Where you want to go eat? Taco stand or something?
Is that taco truck still running around town?
No, ain't been...
Was snowed, he probably snowed
they,
in.
Well, they ran from the border, from what I understand.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
Where can we go?
Something to do with Trump. I don't know what it was.
Trump.
Yeah.
I'm Trump. Scared of him, too. But Trump. You know what? He's going to be the president. I'm backing him 100%.
Oh, you ain't got to worry about
we
it.
We need to take this down, get a Trump sign.
Don't worry. He's phasing himself out now. He ain't even attending the presidential debates, I hear.
He don't have to.
So he's phasing himself out.
We need to get a Trump sign. I'm supporting Trump.
We don't need to get a Trump sign. We just need to run as an independent.
Nope, I'm supporting Trump.
If he don't show up,
I send him my donation.
Oh, great.
I am funding the Trump team.
Oh, great.
Yep.
Guess he done suckered you into making an investment.
No, I donated.
You donated?
I donated.
What did you need, a tax write-off at the end of the year to save your tail?
I did.
Oh, that's what I figured.
Yep.
All right,
well.
Oh my goodness.
We need some hats back on the show.
Gout's about to kill me, man.
No, I tell you, have to phase the women and the bacon out, you'll be all right.
I tell you, I don't.